Ogno Dice, Wikipedia article audio. Ogno Dice or Ogno Dice, 4th century BCE, was supposedly the first female midwife or physician in ancient Athens. Her story is told by the Roman author Gaius Julius Hyginus in his Fabulae. Ogno Dice is not generally believed to be a historical figure, but her story has been frequently deployed as a precedent for women practicing midwifery or medicine. According to Hyginus, Ogno Dice studied medicine under Herophilus, and worked as a physician in her home city of Athens disguised as a man, because women at the time were forbidden from practicing medicine. As her popularity with female patients grew, rival physicians accused her of seducing the women of Athens. She was tried, and revealed her sex to the jury by lifting her tunic. Accused of illegally practicing medicine as a woman, she was defended by the women of Athens, who praised her for her effective treatments. She was acquitted, and the law against female physicians in Athens was revoked. Life. Historicity. Ogno Dice lived in ancient Athens, where at the time women were forbidden from studying medicine. In order to learn medicine, Ogno Dice disguised herself as a man, cutting her hair short, and studied under Herophilus. Having trained as a physician, Ogno Dice tried to assist women in labor, who were ashamed of, or blatantly refused to consult male practitioners. In one case, Ogno Dice therefore revealed her sex and was permitted to treat the woman. Other doctors, growing jealous of Agnotis' success, accused her of seducing her patients. On trial before the Areopagus, Ogno Dice once again lifted her clothes, revealing that she was a woman. She was then charged with breaking the law which forbade women from practicing medicine, but was defended by the wives of important Athenians whom she had treated. In response to this, the law was changed to allow women to practice medicine. Hyginus describes Ogno Dice as an obstetrix. It is difficult to know how to translate this into English. Sarah Pomeroy has rendered it as obstetrician, arguing that midwives existed in Athens in Agnotis' day, but that Ogno Dice was distinguished by her formal education in medicine. However, Helen King notes that there was no formal licensing system for medics in the ancient world, and that it is anachronistic to divide ancient healers into the distinct categories of midwife and obstetrician. Modern scholars generally doubt that Ogno Dice was a real historical figure. Problems with accepting Ogno Dice as historical include questions over her date, and the implausibility of Hyginus' claim that there were no obstetrics in Athens before Ogno Dice, when literary and epigraphic evidence shows that midwives were known. Hyginus claims that Ogno Dice was taught medicine by Herophilus, generally identified with Herophilus of Chalcedon, an ancient physician known for his work on gynecology, who was credited with the discovery of the ovaries. If this is the case, Ogno Dice would have lived in the late 4th or early 3rd century BC. Those who believe in the historicity of Ogno Dice have come to two separate conclusions explaining the lack of midwives in Athens before her. The first theory is that there were no midwives prior to Ogno Dice. Alternatively, it has been proposed that there were earlier midwives, but they had been forbidden by law from practicing. This second theory has been elaborated over time, with Kate Hurd Mead, in 1938, being the first to propose that women had been forbidden from practicing medicine because they had been accused of performing abortions. The story of Ogno Dice has been invoked since the 16th century to provide precedents for a range of gender options within the medical profession. While some later users of the story focused on the midwifery claims in the opening line, for example arguing that men were midwives before women were, or that women were midwives first, others have concentrated on what Ognodice is supposed to have learned from Herophilus, which was medicine rather than midwifery. Thus she was used both in the peak of men midwifery in the 18th century and in women's struggle to enter the medical profession in the 19th century. Elizabeth Sellier, the 17th century Popish midwife, positioned herself as a modern Ognodice. Influence on women in medicine. However, others have taken the story of Ognodice as a negative example. Augustus Gardner, for instance, in 1851 delivered a lecture arguing that, literally, no improvement was made in the many centuries where midwifery was a women's profession, comparing Ognodice to the 19th century abortionist Madame Restall. Notes.